Today we'll be using FlexGrid in Angular, but all WYSIWYG mode controls can be used in React, Vue, or pure JS applications. This is a new Angular project. We have a source folder with component markup and TypeScript, as well as modules and style sheets. So to get started, we simply install WYSIWYG mode from NPM. We have hundreds of packages, but you can install all the Angular packages by using this command, which is npm install at grapecity/wygmo.angular2.all. And this basically is a bundle. It'll install everything you need to use WYSIWYG mode in Angular applications. Then we need to import the grid module in order to use FlexGrid. And in our component, we will need to import some base modules as well. To bind the data grid, we start with a simple JS array of objects. In this example, we are generating records in a getSalesData function. We have a loop and make JS objects to be added to the array. The type of data is meant to be from a sales application. Lastly, we're going to put the array into a collection view, which is an observable collection that makes data binding simple. Now, all we need to do is declare our FlexGrid in markup. We add the FlexGrid markup in the app component. And then we bind the grid's item source property to our array of data. And that's it. We run the project, and we can see that the grid is working. It has generated all the columns based on our object. It supports scrolling with virtualization. It supports sorting, selection, including range selection. It also supports editing, and even data validation. So you can see, if we would try to enter a string into a numeric column, it won't let me commit that edit. I mentioned virtualization, and this is key to FlexGrid's incredible performance. We virtualize by default, and that's what makes the grid the fastest on the market. So let's change from 50 records to 500,000 records, and let's see how that affects performance. So we go back to our app. Now we've got 500,000 records rendered in the grid just as quickly. And you can see there's smooth scrolling. I can go all the way to the top, the bottom. I can also do range selection all the way to the bottom or top. I can use keyboard navigation to smoothly scroll all the way down 500,000 records with no lags in performance. And again, this is all due to our virtualization. So binding FlexGrid to an array, we had a fully functional grid. Now, let's make it a little nicer. The first thing we want to do is define our columns. So one by one, we can add the columns so that the grid's not automatically creating columns based on the data source. This allows us to explicitly define what columns we want displayed. And columns don't have to match up exactly to the data source. You can choose which columns to show in which order. You can also add custom heading text and configure lots of different properties on the columns as well. So we can add all the columns we want. We'll give them friendlier names. And then we can run the project and see that now the grid is showing exactly what we want instead of just showing all the columns from the data source. Okay, so now that we've got our columns defined, let's do some more improvements. The first thing I want to do is format the data. Wijmo has a very nice globalization API built into it. And what we can do is format data based on the current culture. The default is US English, but we support about 50 different cultures from around the world so that you can format data and get localized strings in any of those cultures. So to add formatting, we are first going to the ID column. It should not have commas in the number, so we'll actually format as a string instead of a number. Second, the quote amount column is a dollar value, so let's format that as a currency. That's it. Yeah, so let's run that and see how it looks. Now you can see that the ID is just a string. It no longer has commas in it. And the quote amount is a currency value. You can see the dollar sign there. And Wijmo format strings are based on the .NET standard. So we try to support as many of those as we can. All right, so the next thing we want to look at is cell templates. Cell templates is one of the most flexible features in FlexGrid. It really allows you to customize the content of any cell. So inside those cell templates, you can use other components. You can use plain HTML. You can use strings. And also, you can use binding syntax and binding expressions. So let's go ahead and enhance one of our columns. We'll start with the customer column. Let's add some custom HTML, like a div tag. And then we can add some bindings that change the avatar based on the data. So we're basically displaying a little avatar next to the customer name, and we're going to put their initials in it. So then we add bindings inside the div tag that are going to render the customer's initials. And after that, we're going to also add bindings with the customer's full name in it so that the full name displays after the avatar. Now when we run the app, our customer column should have some beautiful colors in it. There we go. So now we can see we've got this nice little circle avatar in the customer column displaying the initials for each customer. And that color is also data bound based on the profile. So another common use for cell templates is images. I think we could continue to enhance our grid by adding some images in some different columns. Let's add a template in the location column so we can display a flag for the country of the location. So we add a template. Inside that template, we add an image where the source for that image is data bound to something coming from our data source. And then after that image, we also have just the string binding for the location name or the country. And it's as simple as that. You can add that image markup right inside the template. Let's go ahead and add another image for the sales agent. We want to display a profile picture for the sales agent so we can see who we're talking about. Similarly, we're going to bind the source for that image to a column in our data source, and then add the sales agent's name after the image. Now when we run the application, our grid is looking much nicer. Now we have a flag displayed for the location and a profile picture for the sales agent in each column. And note that the performance hasn't changed at all. We're still able to smoothly scroll, use the grid, all while these templates are being applied and rendered in the grid. And again, that's due to virtualization being the default. All right, another powerful use for cell templates is conditional formatting. So conditional formatting is used for visually showing differences in data, especially when you're trying to highlight something important. So let's add a special indicator in the quote status column, and we'll use conditional formatting to color code it so people will easily be able to see the difference of statuses for each row. Okay, so let's start with a template, a cell template. Inside that, we'll add a div and a span tag. And essentially, we will be writing a little code to check the value for the order status property. So if it's complete, we add a complete class. If it's pending, we add a pending class. If it's closed, we add a closed class. And really, you could do any kind of logic in here like this. This is just a very simple implementation of it. Then we just add those classes to our CSS, and basically what they're doing is just changing the background color of the span tag. Go back to our application, and we can see that now the quote status is displaying red, yellow, and green little indicators, so it's really easy to visually see the difference in those rows. All right, another use for cell templates is adding custom components. So this is where you can really get some complex cell renderings and really nice editors or visualizations. Let's add a visualization. So in the lead confidence column, we're going to render that value in a gauge, a linear gauge. So we're going to import the modules that we need to use the gauge. After we have those imported, we can use the markup. So inside that lead confidence column, we add a template. And then inside that template, we can declare our linear gauge. Now the WGMO linear gauge can be fully expressed in markup, just like the other components. And then the key thing here is we're binding the value of the linear gauge to the lead confidence property in our record. And now when we see the app here, you can see we have this really nice visualization where we're showing the lead confidence in a linear gauge. So as we scroll down the grid, it's very eye-popping. We can see which ones are high, which ones are low. And then again, quickly check out the status as well with the indicators. So FlexGrid is fast and lightweight because only the key features are included in the grid module. For special features or maybe more niche features, we offer optional extensions that you can pick and choose from as you need. So that keeps your application much leaner, so you're only including what you need, and it keeps our grid very lightweight. So we're actually going to now add a checkbox column. So you can have a really nice way of checking each row in the grid. So first, we have to import that extension. So we have a module called widgmo.gridSelector. We import that. After we import it, we initialize that class in our TypeScript file, and we point it to the grid that we want to render that column in, and that's essentially all we need to do. We import and then initialize it. Then when we go back to our app, you can see that first column is now a checkbox column. It supports multiple selection. It's selecting the rows as we check and uncheck. And then there's a tri-state checkbox up in the header column. And that's a really convenient way for checking or unchecking all. So really, really nice feature you get with very little code. Another extension we offer is full text search. So let's add it so people can quickly find records in the grid. In order to add full text search, we have to import the search module and do that in both our component and our modules. Beyond that, then we can actually go into the markup and we have a little toolbar up above the grid. We're going to insert this FlexGrid search component inside that toolbar. And the important part there is that we are pointing the FlexGrid search component to our grid. So you can have multiple grids on the page, multiple search components, and you can point them at the grid you want associated with. So we go back to our app, and now we can see there is a search box above our grid. We can type in and actually filter results. You can do multi-column searching. So here we're going to type in Russia, and then it'll only show Russian orders. Then we further filter it by adding a pending, and then it shows only pending orders in Russia. So really a powerful way to help end users, lets them quickly find records in your grid. All right, so probably our most popular extension is the Excel-like filter. A lot of end users like the Excel experience when filtering data grids, so we have built something very similar to that. Again, this is an optional extension, so to use it, we have to import the module into our application. Once we have it all imported, we're able to go inside the grid's markup. We add the FlexGrid filter markup, which is its own component, inside the grid. That lets the filter know which grid it's associated with by putting it inside the flex grid of your choice. And now we go back to the application. We can see there's a little filter icon in every header. We can open the filter. We can check or uncheck all that we want to filter. So here we're looking at filtering by condition. Now we're just showing only orders from Japan. Alternately, we can only unselect one of them, so we're showing closed and complete orders but not pending orders. And then we can quickly clear the filters. And then really interestingly, there is a filter by condition. Sorry, we were talking about filter by value. Now we're talking about filter by condition, where basically it allows you to filter with special conditions based on the data type. So in this instance, let's filter everything where the lead confidence is higher than 60. So really nice way of creating multiple columns of filters on the grid, requiring very, very little code, essentially just importing the extension and adding it to the app. So you can see we were able to quickly get a grid into our application with just importing the modules, adding a few lines of code. And then we could easily add on top of that to enable some of our built-in features, to use some of our cell templates to really customize rendering. And then, of course, including some of our optional extensions that really enhance the grid and make it even more powerful than the default. So soon enough, we essentially ended up with a data grid that end users will appreciate. They'll love to work with it. It'll have those familiar experiences like the keyboard navigation, smooth scrolling. FlexGrid has the Excel-like filtering, so it'll feel very familiar to people. So we hope you'll give FlexGrid a try. We think you can literally build anything with it.